My precious young friends, if somebody would ask us what's the most important step in life, of course we could indicate to certain aspects of our lives, but overall the most important step in life is the passing from being under the care of other people or under being the responsibility, you are the responsibility of others, to become responsible yourself and assuming your share of responsibility. That's not an event, it's not a moment, it's a way of life. Permanently, always, we must be watching for the calling of the responsibility. What is my responsibility in this situation? Well, when we are born, naturally, we are under the care and responsibility of our parents. Feeding, cleaning, growing, changing, everything is under them. Well, sometimes this part of our life, this leg of our journey, gives us such a satisfaction that some people extend it all the way to 40 or 60 or forever. They remain childish in their attitude. It is extremely dangerous. It will limit and even destroy completely your own destiny, your own contribution to life in this society. There comes a time when you see in the little one the tendency, no, I want to do it myself. I want to do it myself. And sometimes parents take a shortcut. No, let me do it for you because it's going to take too much time. No, we must stimulate. We must feed this tendency that we see in our children. But as I'm talking to you, young people, and in fact, everybody listening to this material, when you observe that somebody is overcaring and somebody is taking some burdens from you that you should bear and doing for you some things that you should do, of course, that's it's somehow beautiful and emotional as an event. It's nostalgic somehow. But when this becomes a way of life and you see a mature man and even a man in his full maturity being under the care of the parents, that is a real serious problem. So do not accept this kind of overcaring from your parents. They will destroy literally the development of your sense of responsibility. How did Jesus deal with this aspect? That's absolutely stunning. When his mother, Mary, came and started directing him, they don't have wine anymore, that's John chapter 3, they don't have wine anymore, and you do something for them. He turned to her, he was in his 30s, he turned to her and said, "Woman, what do I have to do with you?" Well, it's this word, woman, it's kind of hurting to tell your mom, woman. But let's not misunderstand. Jesus was in full responsibility of his messianic call. So he communicated Mary a very good news. "I am fully responsible. Do not try to take care of the things that I am supposed to take care of. Let's work in this area in our own lives, both in avoiding to be overprotective, overcaring, and stuff like that. And second, do not accept any aspect, even in the family. Sometimes wives and husbands, they try to spare the other one or do what they would be, what your husband or wife would be supposed to do. So refuse that kindly. Tell them, "I am fully responsible. It's my part. It's my duty. I will do it right now." That will strengthen your power of being and becoming responsible and taking your share of responsibility. It's not just an aspect of education or growing or raising a child or becoming some. It's not. It goes all the way into the spiritual realm. So people that became addicted of being taken care of by other people, they became addicted of being a burden and of being other people's responsibility. People that have this type of addiction, they tend to do the same in the spiritual area. The church did a mixed job, I would say. Not in all cases and methods and ways I can see this determination to create a body of responsible people. Most of the time we see people, we see a body of dependent people, addicted people. They don't study for themselves because the minister is going to deliver the sermon. He studies for them. He watches for them. He's taking care of everything. That creates a generation of immature people. They can't take care of themselves, let alone being responsible, taking the share of responsibility for others. Concerning the Bible study, concerning the understanding of spiritual things, the church has this tendency or grave sin of creating people, immature, spiritually immature people. Let's read together in Hebrews 5:12. You have been believers so long, now that you ought to be teaching others. You're already, that's why God was growing you from learning from others to become teachers, to take the knowledge, the spiritual revelation, and transfer it to others as it's your duty, because other people transfer it to you. So you have the same. You have been believers so long now that you ought to be teaching others. Instead, you need someone to teach you again the basic things about God's word. So I was in a church, and I literally felt a deep pain in my heart when elderly people were treated like children. Mature people I'm talking about, they were treated like children in the kindergarten. And the word that was presented to them, the illustration and everything, it could be very good for a children's hour, but to treat this congregation, these people, with this kind of methods, that was painful. And I realized that it was a long process of transforming mature people or keeping them in the childish mentality. Let's read on right here in Hebrews chapter 5:12. You are like babies who need milk and cannot eat solid food. After being for so long in the church, after having your own Bible, after knowing God personally, being baptized in the name of your personal Savior, you need milk. And the Word of God continues. For someone who lives on milk is still an infant and doesn't know how to do what is right. Minister or elder or family, or how should I do that? How should I do the other one? This is too late in life for us, too risky, too dangerous to give up our responsibility, our maturity. We only have one chance in life to become mature and responsible people, and literally to give up this right, this opportunity once in a lifetime. It's extremely dangerous. So Hebrews chapter 6 says, let us stop going over the basic teachings about Christ again and again. Let us go on instead of becoming mature in our understanding. Surely we don't need to start again the fundamental, all the basic things of sin and repentance, of faith in God and things like that. That's the foundation. It was laid already. Let's grow in understanding. So in 1 Corinthians 3:1, dear brothers and sisters, when I was with you, you couldn't talk. I couldn't talk to you as I would to spiritual people. I had to talk as though you belonged to this world or as though you were infants in Christ. That's the phenomena of literally keeping people in an infantile state of mind, both intellectually or materially, but more gravely spiritually. Jesus had, I have many things to tell to you, but you know, you cannot take it. Why? Because you didn't keep pace with the light. So, beloved friends, do not overcare for anybody. Give that person a chance to become mature, to organize his own desk, to clean his own room, to prepare his own food or her own food. Give that person a chance. Do not be overcaring. Do not exaggerate in this area. Second, do not accept any exaggeration, both from family or society or government. Oh, they want money from the government. They want the government to take care of themselves. That creates a society that is sick with infantilism, a disease of the brain, of the mind, of the life. In fact, a life disease that keeps a person in an infantile status. No, we are not to be taken care of. We are ready to take care of others. If there is a person that really needs being taken care of, that person still, like somebody in a wheelchair or somebody sick, or that person will look for those things that can be done. I can do this myself. I will do it myself. I don't want you to do it for me. As long as I got to know a man that was born armless, and that was not a pleasant experience at all. What a struggle in life. But this man, he was never on state help or any kind of pension. No, he was born armless. He worked in the Air Force, then he works in the cinema industry. And I invited him on the platform of the church I was pastoring at that time, and he stood there like a living example that we should take responsibility in the limits, of course, of our condition and situation. May God lead us to understand the importance and to understand the consequences of this kind of attitude about the most important step in life, which is crossing or passing for being taken care of to taking care of yourself and of others. Precious Lord, help us to be mature people in Christ, to help us to take responsibility over ourselves and our share of responsibility with others around, and in a special, very special way in the spiritual area, help us to grow into mature spiritual men and women, ladies and gentlemen, young people. Help us grow in our relationship with you. And thank you very much for everything you prepared for us and preparing us for what you are ready to offer. In Jesus' name, amen.